This
all come
conference
because
will
of that.
now be recorded.
Because of the hexagonal shape. Hexagonal? Why not, sir? Rectangular. Why not triangle? Why not circle? Why hexagon? Yes. Hexagon is the best option or the shape that can be used to divide the spherical shape. As the globe is a spherical shape, we want to divide the whole places. Hexagon is the best option. So it is in the hexagonal shape, and each hexagon is called a cell. That is the reason we have a short name called cell phones, phones that are all using in the cell. And we have a different frequency for each cell. That means the tower that particular cell belongs will have a different frequency, and the next cell or next tower that is having the a cell which is occupying the tower which is occupying the next cell will have other frequency. Both will not be the same. If it has the same, it will overlap. Does it means that no? If you take Delhi or Udaipur, there are hundreds of towers. That means hundreds of frequencies are used. No, it has concept called reusable of frequencies. Seven towers will be given one frequency, and it will be in a group, and other seven towers will be having other frequency. Again, the same frequency is used. So seven frequency is sufficient for dividing the whole area into different frequency concept. And cell phones are very nice, in the sense, very nice to use, not like our police walkie-talkie. In police walkie-talkie, at a time one person can talk, others can listen. When other person is talking, I cannot talk. But in cell phones, it is called, we have a concept called full duplex. Full duplex, main bhi baat karunga, opposite wala bhi baat kar sakta hai. We both can send and receive the voice or data. So full duplex. Half duplex is only one thing we can send, one frequency we can send. But in full duplex, we can also send as well as we can also receive. So yeah, we have different G's. ये तो हमने सुना होगा 1G, 2G, 3G. It is not just 2G. We have also 2.5, 2.75. Latest mobile. Yes, I will come to the unlocking in very few minutes, because you have given me 2 hours of time till 4 o'clock, I hope. So I will cover that part, that point also. We lost, there's a question, how to retrieve all the data from logged Android latest mobile. Recently we lost one of my family member, and we don't know the lock pattern to unlock. Is there any option to unlock it? It is, if it is my personal issue. Yeah, no issues. We'll talk about that very soon. Yeah. So different G's are there. So is G's ke jo concept hai, I don't want to go much detail. Forensic point of view se main baat karna chahta hoon. So the 2G, from 2G onwards, we have got the data. Data aane laga. In the sense, it is not only the voice we send and receive. Now we start receiving the data. And now we are talking about 5G. More speed of data is there. And we have more option, or forensically we can do much with the 5G phone. Bahut sara data hai, bahut sara material information milega. And the concept jo hai cell phone ka, again jo ek city ka hai, usme it will be given one channel, yani ki itne ye frequency is city mein use karna hai. So it is again divided into different channels. So agar koi cell phone yahan se bahar chala gaya to dusri jagah chala gaya, we can find the cell phones based on the different frequency it is started using, and we can locate the geographical location of the own as well. And yeah, very this information we need to understand a little bit. The phone, the mobile phone has two things: mobile unit and the unique integrated circuit card. पहले तो इसको unique integrated circuit card ही बोलते हैं, उसके बाद इसको SIM card नाम दिया गया है. So a mobile unit is a hardware device. It has got various modules, यानी कि camera एक module, माइक स्पीकर एक मॉड्यूल, फोन का मॉड्यूल, मोडम एक मॉड्यूल. सो डिफरेंट मॉड्यूल्स आर मेड टुगेदर एंड द फोन विल हैव एन यूनिक मोबाइल नंबर. दैट नंबर इज कॉल्ड IMEI, इंटरनेशनल मोबाइल इक्विपमेंट आइडेंटिटी. पहले तो इसको टैम्पर किया जा सकता था, टैम्पर करते थे. आजकल लॉ सेज दैट यू मस्ट नॉट टैम्पर. इफ इट इज समबडी इज यूजिंग द टैम्परिंग, then it is a punishable offense. Okay, similarly the SIM card has got one more unique number. This number is IMSI. By chance if you get a SIM card kahin par aapko mila, Cinefra mein mila, ya road pe mila, us SIM card ko, if you take a SIM card, you can find the number, the subscriber, all those details from the SIM card. The number that will be written on that itself will provide you sufficient information wo kaun sa service provider hai. If you have tool, you can use the tool and you can extract in particular uska number aur uska authentication details hum usko ja sakte hain. Okay, right, just for simple information, let me go into the concept of forensics now. Mobile phone, when you take the mobile phone forensics, it has got three unique stages. First stage, seizure. You have to seize the phone properly. The phone, if you don't seize it properly, it might lead to tampering or loss of evidence. I will tell you what are the things to be followed. Then we have to look into the acquisition. We have to use certain tools for certain type of mobile phones or certain method for certain mobile phones to acquire the data. When you acquire the data, it might not be so easy to understand. You have to analyze it and then you have to make it as an evidence. So let me put some light on the concept of seizure, seizing the device. There are four basic rules when you seize a mobile phone. The first rule is that stop the reception. Stop the reception. Yes, you must make the phone not to receive any call, any message. First question, why sir, why we must not make the phone not to receive any call? Any guess? Or any message? Any guess from any from the participants? Why we must not receive a call? Okay, the answer might be, sir, volatile memory tamper ho jayega. Absolutely. Data kuch extra aa jayega. Absolutely. But the very important point here is we must stop the reception of the signal in order to protect the already saved data in the device. What will happen, sir, if I don't stop? Yes, if you don't stop the signal reception of the phone, the criminal or the person known to the criminal from where you have seized the phone can send a message by which the whole data will be wiped out. So we must stop the phone not to receive the signal. Okay, how to make the phone not to receive the signal? Haan sir, ye bhi to hai. चलो जनरली फोरेंसिकली व्हाट वी यूज टू रेकमेंड, यूज द फैराडे बैग. दैट इज अ बैग कॉल्ड फैराडे बैग विच हैज गॉट इलेक्ट्रिक आई मीन मेटल मेश इन साइड. And you, once you put that mobile phone in the Faraday bag, it will not receive not only tower signal, Wi-Fi signal, IR or whatever signal, it will not receive at all. So no one can send a message and tamper the or delete the or wipe the data from the mobile phone. Sir, if I don't have the Faraday bag, what should I do then? If you don't have the Faraday bag, then you can go for caller zero. Okay, you can go for something called, you know, people used to say aeroplane mode. Aeroplane mode. Agar aeroplane mode, if you could not go, then what should we do, sir? Aluminium foil aisa jo roti pack karte hain, we can put the phone in that aluminium foil, pack it properly, and it will not receive, sir. I have tested it. Yes, you are absolutely right, but the international standard says you must not use aluminium foil. Why? Because is anyone to tell something? Okay, so the aluminium foil might not be having the same thickness, or it might get cut. So it will once it is get cut, you might receive the signal and the whole data might go. So stop the signal with a proper method. So aluminium foil is not used. So what is the Indian jugaad or international jugaad? You can use the anti-static cover. You can put two, three anti-static cover, one inside another, make a pouch, and then inside you can keep the mobile phone and wrap it, and the particular anti-static cover will not receive any signal inside. So this is the accepted international jugaad. Then we have to maintain the power. We have to give the power, because if you put the phone in such a situation, it will try to take more power and try to get the signal. So it will eat out the power. In order to give the power, you cannot use an external source and connect it to the phone, kept it in the Faraday bag. If you connect that external source, the wire through which the power is coming will become as an antenna, and it might receive the signal. So you must not use the external source. The other option we have is that you can use the battery bank, connect the device to the battery bank, the phone, and then put both the device in the Faraday bag. Then it will not receive any signal. At the same time, the power will also be maintained. When you seize, you also need to seize the cables and accessories. Many a times we have seen in a situation, this is the Faraday bag and this is the accessories. So many a time we have a situation when the phone has got a unique charger, unique docking station, which no sir wahin par hi tha, Sina frame mein tha, chhod ke aa gaye, ab चार्ज नहीं कर पा रहे हैं, एंड वी आर नॉट एबल टू यूज द डिवाइस. सो यू हैव टू सीज दिस टू थिंग्स फ्रॉम द एक्सेसरीज, स्पेशली द चार्जर एंड द डॉकिंग स्टेशन. इफ देयर इज एनीथिंग और दैट इज कनेक्टेड टू द सिस्टम और द एक्सटर्नल डिवाइस, नीड टू बी कनेक्टेड सो दैट वी कैन लुक इनटू इट एंड डू द प्रॉपर एक्टिविटी. द फोर्थ इंपॉर्टेंट रूल इज दैट acquisition under controlled condition. Acquisition under controlled condition. Sir, maine phone ko seize kiya. The police officer says, I seized the phone properly, and as per the instruction, I put it in the Faraday bag, and I brought it to the station or to the lab. The moment I take the phone out in the lab or the police station, it received one message, and the whole data started wiping. That means you just cannot take the phone out when you just reach the lab or the police station or the office where you have to do the work. You have to open it in a controlled condition or remove it from the Faraday bag in a controlled condition. Even after removing, it must not receive any message. So what is the controlled condition? We have something called Faraday tent or Faraday cage or Faraday box. Okay. So उसी में आपको पहले बैग को टेंट में आपको बैग के अंदर लेना है और बैग के अंदर से फोन निकालना है. So this is what the method we have to follow. And a very important thing, never clean the mobile phone, especially the screen. If you clean the mobile phone screen, we may lose the first option to recover the password. Is it I'm audible? I got a message that connection problem. Is it I'm audible to you all? Is it I'm visible? Mera visible, audible? If everything is clear.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir. You are audible.
Yes. Thank you. Never clean the screen of the mobile phone. सर मैंने सीन ऑफ क्राइम में गया, वो बंदा था, उसका हाथ ना पसीने से हो गया था, फोन हैज गॉट नो डर्टी. आई टुक येलो क्लॉथ एंड प्रॉपरली क्लीन्ड इट एंड पैक्ड इट इन द फैराडे बैग. सर एब्सोल्युटली रॉन्ग यू हैव डन. सो यू मस्ट नॉट, बिकॉज यू कैन टिल्ट योर ओन टिल्ट एंड सी, यू कैन सी द पैटर्न लॉक. Since you have put the pattern lock pattern for several times or opened the lock several times, that is a marking on it. Pattern hi bol raha hu sir, pin code dal diya hai sir mera, to wo kya karna hai, wo bhi koshish kar sakte. Maximum 4 pins, 4 numbers will be there. Out of 9 or 10 numbers you have the 4 numbers, from that you can try to crack it. So never clean the mobile phone, you can get the pattern possibility there. Any question in doubt so far? Any question in doubt? No. Okay, right. Now let us go little the second part, analysis part. Before we go, just a second. Any question now? Somebody has put Anita Goyal is trying to say something. Yes, yes, Anita, please. You can type in your question. I'll take your question. Hello. Yes, please. Good afternoon. Okay. Issues. You can type your questions if you want. Okay. I thought you somebody might be asking some question. So this is what the procedure first to seize the mobile phone. If you miss, your data might get lost. And one more very important thing you have to understand. I have seen many cases in FSL that the live phone they will put into the candy box, plastic candy box, and send it to FSL. That's a very big mistake. If you don't have the tools available for the live forensics, the option that you have to suggest to the police or the person who is seizing the devices in the scene of crime, switch off the phone and then pack it. Don't keep the phone live and send it. Okay. Now to acquisition, data acquisition. Before we go into the acquisition, once you seize the phone, you have to look into what are the operating systems. Yes, to acquire the data, we use different tool for different operating system. One the famous operating system for mobile phones we have is Android, Google Android. Around 80 to 90% of the phones around the globe has got Android. So if it is Android, we will use certain tools. And then we can go for the high-end tool, iOS, Apple iOS. This tool might, this phone might be a quite tough phone if it is locked. If it is locked, the latest phones are quite difficult to open. Only one company will support the law enforcement agencies, that is Cellebrite. They have the tool to crack, but those tools are very costly. Then we have the third operating system, little bit in use, which are all Windows. So you have to confirm which phone it is, which model it is, and what is the operating system. Based on that, you can decide which tool to be used. Before you go into the tool concept, you have to understand the methods of data extraction. There are around five methods we can say. The first or the basic method is manual extraction. That is, I have a phone. The phone is an older model phone. That is that, you know, keypad wala. And you want to extract the data. I can damn sure say the tools that we have at present will not work for this phone. Compatibility nahi rahega. Sir, case hai, kaisa isko hum data extract karna hai. So the option is manual extraction. Manual extraction mein aap yahi karenge. That is, you will open the phone. उसको पासवर्ड का कोई दिक्कत नहीं है, वो एक स्टार बटन को कंटिन्यूस प्रेस करना पड़ता है, वही रहता है मोस्टली. सो यू ओपन द फोन, कीप द फोन इन द अंडर द कैमरा लाइक दिस सेटअप एंड स्टार्ट कैप्चरिंग द स्क्रीन्स. एंड जो कुछ भी स्क्रीन में दिखता है . Is there any tool that can be used for every operating system? Certain tools can say, for example, Cellebrite. My tools ke bare mein thode der ke baad bolne wala tha. Thode tools say, for example, jo abhi market mein jo Cellebrite chalta hai, it can accommodate few models of Android, few models of Apple and few models of Windows, not to every mobile device. ये एक बड़ा issue भी होता है. MHA से भी एक list of tools आया हुआ है. हम पहले बोलते थे, अरे सर mobile phone के लिए tool लेके दो, please provide us tool for mobile phone extraction. The tool costs around 30 lakh rupees. Once we purchase the tool, we can use only for 50% of the phone that is available in the market. Koi phone aa gaya aur wo apna tool se nahi ho raha hai, then we have to ask for one more tool. Jab ladai hoti hai, are yaar 30 lakh ka abhi aapko tool leke dilaya hai, tum fir se tool poch rahe ho. Yes, we don't have a single tool for all the phones. It is absolutely difficult for us now at the present situation. No single tool can be used. Even MHA has given the list. These are all the tools you must have in your lab to do the mobile phone forensics. Okay. So first point is manual extraction. Manual extraction mein kuch bhi nahi karna hai. Phone ko rakhna hai. Agar password to nahi rahega usme purane phone mein. और पासवर्ड अगर नहीं रहेगा तो बढ़िया, तो आपको फोटो कैमरा के नीचे रख के यू हैव टू टेक द फोटोज एंड कोर्ट विल एक्सेप्ट दिस फोटोज. वंस यू प्रोड्यूस द फोन विद द फोटोज, द कोर्ट विल टेक इट एज एन एविडेंस. दिस इज व्हाट द मैनुअल एक्सट्रैक्शन. चलो भाई, मैनुअल एक्सट्रैक्शन जो कुछ है पुराने फोन को कर दिया, पुराना मॉडल. देन वी हैव समथिंग कॉल्ड लॉजिकल एक्सट्रैक्शन. थोड़े फोन्स थोड़ा एडवांस फोन्स, not the latest, the 3G wale phone samajho. These phones can be used by a system to extract the data, but the data which it will extract is not the whole data that is available in the phone, only visible data. Whatever that is visible on the screen, any key deleted, hidden, you cannot access. Whatever you can see, message gaya hai, message hai, ye hai, dikhta hai, usi cheez ko hum extract karte hain. That is what there was an urgent call. So logical extraction, whatever visible data is there, it will be extracted, not the hidden or deleted data. So you just use this tool to take the logical data. Sir, hello. So if you want to extract the deleted file or hidden file, you need to do the physical extraction. So once you do the physical extraction, the whole memory dump will be taken out, and you can access the memory dump or the dump, the flash memory dump, and the deleted, hidden, all the data can be taken and you can analyze. Sir, the phone is slightly damaged. It is not getting switched on. Wo switch on nahi ho raha hai. To kya karna hai? We have something called JTAG. Yani ki, we can use the reset points of the motherboard and go to the chip level and extract the data from the particular chip. This is a very टेक्निकल प्रोसेस. थोड़ी सी भी गलती हो गई, पिन को थोड़ा सा माइक्रो लेवल में, माइक्रोस्कोप में देख के करना पड़ता है, ये थोड़ा सा गलत से लग गया, बस चिट आवाज आएगी, पूरा डेटा गया. सो इट हैज टू बी प्रॉपरली प्रोब्स हैज टू बी प्रॉपरली फिक्स्ड एंड द डेटा हैज टू बी टेकन फ्रॉम द चिप थ्रू द मदरबोर्ड ऑफ द मोबाइल फोन. दिस इज वॉट वी कॉल JTAG. JTAG is a costly tool. It costs around 1 crore rupee for the labs to have. So JTAG is the next option. Sir, wo thoda sa niche gir gaya, janbujh ke wo pheka, and the damage, the phone has also damaged, and the by damage is severe damage hai, wo board bhi crack ho gaya hai. Our board is also having some problem. I'm not able to use the JTAG to reach to the chip. So other option we have, that is called chip off. Yani ki, you have to remove the chip from the board and then mount it in a laboratory setting, and then you have to put again micro probes into the sufficient pins of the chip and then extract the data. Bolne mein to bahut aasan hai, pehla dikkat hai extracting the chip from the board. You have to give exact temperature. Little lesser, the chip will not come out. Little 1 degree higher, the chip will burn. So you have to use exact temperature. वो तो maintain नहीं हो पाएगा sir situation में. अगर 1 degree भी जाए तो होगा तो गया. So what to do? So what people used to do? They grind the motherboard को ही grind करके, and then they will take the chip. So we have to remove the board, grind it with the proper cooling, all other things and all, and then we have to extract the chip, and then we will take the data. So this is the very critical way of handling that device to extract. अगर चिप भी ठीक से नहीं काम करे, चिप भी थोड़ा सा टूटा हुआ है या कोई डैम्पर हुआ है, तो डेटा कैसा निकाला जा सकता है? There is only one option available now, and it is done by the international organization, not by any, no Indian organization has got this device. It is called MicroRead. What is MicroRead? The flash memory has got various NAND gates. So NAND gates are zeros and ones. You have to read through electron microscope and see which gate is open, and that you have to convert into ASCII, and then you have to make it as a data. So very tedious process, time consuming process, and in very few cases, in international level, the terrorism cases, they have done this, and in India we don't have this facility. Maybe very soon we can have, and this is the ultimate. It's a very time consuming process. So this is these are all the methods we extract the data from the mobile phone. Any question, any doubt so far? Any question you want to ask, you can ask now. What are the data that we can extract? Yes, that is also very important. कोई सर टूल में लगा दिया, पूरा आ गया, पूरा सब आ गया. The main thing is that you have to look into this very important things: address book, call history, SMS. Oh, ये तो जनरल है, फोटो तो जनरल है. Calendar, calendar also plays a very important role. Even map, map also plays a very important role in the cases. From that social networking, the sites the person uses in their mobile phone to interact with others, the social media network, this data helps a lot. We'll talk in detail about social networking forensics in few minutes, and let me show you the tools that are all available in the market to extract the data. XORY Logical. This tool is one of the high-end tool. You can extract data of more than 1,000 different modules of devices. Okay, and it has the ability to extract so much of information from the device. Call, send, receive. Archived calendar, sound files. So XORY Logical is also a very nice tool that is available in the market, and we prefer this tool in the labs also. So out of many tools, one of the XORY is one of the tool labs used to keep. Okay, right. The next tool we have, Yetna. So this is also a tool for live phone data extraction. So most of the time, they switch off the phone and then they boot and they will try to get the data. But this particular tool, when it is in the live condition, it will capture certain information, and it has got also the option for the intelligence. It has got a capacity to embed a program and then try to do the spying. Okay, so you know about Pegasus. So a small program of Pegasus is also available with this, but the package will not come for everybody. Only the selected people can buy it. The other tool, Mobile Edit. Yes, if you want to handle iPhone, Mobile Edit is one of the best tool we can say. It can go, but password breaking is not possible in Mobile Edit. Mobile Edit से password possible नहीं होता है, मगर iPhone का data analyze करने और the phone which has got a unique file system, उसको handle करने के लिए Mobile Edit is a very good tool to use. So people in the lab used to also used to have mobile edit in the repository, specially to handle iPhones. Cellebrite UFED, yes, he is a big player. Mobile phone ka koi bhi forensic ka tool puchoge to FSL se lete hue police officers tak bolenge UFED. Cellebrite UFED. UFED do tarike ke hote hain. One is UFED for PC and another is UFED for cloud. Cloud be touch be a device, it's got touch device, but cloud generally. What is the difference between UFED for PC and UFED for cloud? Yes, UFED for PC can extract the data from the mobile phone to your computer, personal computer. What about UFED for cloud? Yes, you know your phone is always in touch with your Gmail or your WhatsApp or any other application that you run. Even though you switch off and switch on, the mobile phone will always be logged in mode. How come? Because there is a token that gets saved in the mobile phone. If I have a token, I don't need any password to log in. I can directly go to the service provider, that is the Gmail or the WhatsApp or whatever. I can download the data from the cloud to my system. So in Sushant Singh Rathod case also, initially they analyzed the device with the normal tool. Later they used the other tool by which they download the backup also. When they download the backup, तो दूसरा पेंडोरा बॉक्स खुल गया. अरे यार ये कहां से माल माल ये माल कौन दिया, ये माल कहां से आया. तो यू माइट बी नोइंग द केस द माल हूएवर नाउ पीपल हु हैड अ चैट विद अबाउट द माल वेयर ऑल गेट कॉट दे वेयर ब्रॉट टू इन्वेस्टिगेशन. सो दिस इज व्हाट दिस टूल विल डू. इट विल नॉट ओनली टेक द डेटा फ्रॉम द मोबाइल बट यूजिंग द टोकन अवेलेबल इन द मोबाइल डिवाइस. It will go to the cloud and extract the data from the cloud, right? So Cellebrite UFED, so more than 3200 phones it can extract the data. So the main tool, this is one of the main tool in the forensic science labs, UFED, mobile edit and XRY. They must have these three tools in order to handle the mobile phones. Yeah, the fourth tool, very important, Oxygen. That is what the complete food thali, full thali. Agar ye bhi mil gaya, complete thali, complete, you have all that thing. 90% of the phones you can complete the case. Oxygen forensics, yes, Oxygen also does the activity, but to the various other types of phones, especially iPhones, it can do more extraction. चलो अभी बात करते हैं ये पासवर्ड की. सर आपने तो बोल रहे हैं यूफेड सेलिब्रेट यूफेड ऑक्सीजन मोबाइल इट ये पूरा पूरे फोन पासवर्ड को ब्रेक कर देगा. आई एम सॉरी, ओनली फ्यू मोबाइल फोन मॉड्यूल्स these tools can break the password. Guaranteed they will never break all the phones. Some phones UFED can bypass the password module, yani ki it will not go through the password, it will bypass, it will put a small program and bypass the password, and then it will go to the device and help to extract the data. 40% of the phones we can do. Some companies claim passware and UFED wale claim karte hain, we will do pay me extra. Passware uses the brute force attack concept of cracking the password. Brute force, yes. it will use all the options one by one. Sir, इतने सारे option कर रहे हैं तो block कर देता है. हाँ, it will take its own time, but uses automated method of brute force attack and it will try to crack with the dictionary it has got apart from the brute force. So password is claiming that it can break the password of iPhones, but not guaranteed to the latest one. 9 तक वो बोल रहा है, April 9 थोड़े 10 तक करेगा, not more than that. Okay? So for the extreme cases, extreme to extreme cases, I just got few days back this information. UFED will support the law enforcement agencies in cracking the password, but for each cracking the password, it will charge. It has got the know-how of the password of the iPhones and other phones, but it will support only to the law enforcement agencies to crack the password. Not all people can access that. Let me see the question. The password, yes. I need to know from Santosh that whether the what is the model of the phone? Is the model is available? I will check with the tool and I can suggest you the tool which can be used to break. Or you can provide the details about the individual, that is a concept called profiling. We will do the profiling. Based on the profiling, we can use a dictionary attack to break the password. These are the two methods that can be used to break the phone password if the person is no more. Okay, right. Any question read out so far? So earlier tools, whatever we have seen, X or Y, app, mobile edit, UFED or proprietary tools, it might cost lakhs and lakhs of rupees to Redmi 2K. Let me check with the Redmi K20 Pro and I will update you, Santosh. Now you need to know about the free tools, sir. Kuch free tool hi bataiye. Itna costly tool hum classroom mein kaisa practice karenge? Aur practice karne ki bhi zarurat hai taki costly tool use karne ke pehle. So in that case, I can suggest you some open source tools. These are all the open source tools. AF Logical OSE. This is a tool. Isme इतना एडवांस नहीं है, लाखों रुपए का माल कहां है और छोटा मोटा टूल ये कहां से मिलेगा, ये कहां से करेगा. सो AF Logical से आप टूल से कुछ काम करना चाहते हो, यू वांट टू डू वर्क विथ AF Logical ओपन सोर्स टूल, यू हैव टू एनेबल द यूएसबी डीबगिंग ऑप्शन इन द फोन एंड देन यू कैन एक्सट्रैक्ट. यानी कि आपको फोन का पासवर्ड पता रहना चाहिए, उसमें सेटिंग में जाके आप उसमें यूएसबी डीबगिंग करना पड़ेगा. यूएसबी डीबगिंग करने के बाद AF Logical एक छोटा सा प्रोग्राम इस फोन में इंस्टॉल करेगा, उसके बाद यू कैन एक्सट्रैक्ट द डेटा फ्रॉम द डिवाइस. जस्ट टू प्रैक्टिस, यस यू कैन यूज दिस फोरेंसिकली ऑल्सो प्रूवन टूल. कोर्ट कैन ऑल्सो एक्सेप्ट इट्स collection procedure in the cases. Okay, iske ilawa, apart from this, what are the tools we have in open source category? Open source Android forensics, this tool is, it comes as a virtual machine. It is available as a virtual machine. It can be used to take the static and dynamic analysis. आपको जो जेडी जो वर्किंग में है वो भी कर सकते हैं और स्टेशनरी बैठा हुआ वो भी डेटा हम इसमें कर सकते हैं, डेटा एक्सट्रैक्ट कर सकते हैं. सो दिस इज ऑल्सो ए गुड टूल magar it will come as a open, I mean open, it will come as a virtual machine of virtual box ya VMware ko istemal karna padega, and then you have to make the phone get detected in the VMware, and then you have to analyze that tool. Again, Anduril for Windows operating system that brings together different forensic suite. It has got different forensic suite. ये especially for the social media and messaging के लिए ये हम इस्तेमाल करते हैं. We use for the social media data extraction, Skype, Tinder, Viber. So these are all the two social medias that can be extra data can be extracted from this social media using this tool. You can also try with this. And finally, I have one more tool, FTK Imager Lite. FTK Imager is the general tool we use for the hard disk imaging, but this tool can also be used to take the memory dump, not only the computer, but you can also take the memory dump of the mobile phone and you can analyze. Similarly, Linux Memory Extractor Lime, this can also be used to take the memory dump of the phone and you can analyze the network related information from this tool. And finally, I have Now Secure Forensics. This has got now a bunch of forensics tools. It also comes as a virtual image, virtual machine only. You have to download 3 GB of data and the virtual machine will come, and you can use the various bundle of tools. It has also got something called password breaking and also file carving. When a file is damaged, this particular tool will carve it and bring it to a readable format. So I used this tool few years back. It was a nice tool. You can also try with this Now Secure Forensics. Okay, so as I said earlier, social media plays a very important role, especially through the phone. If you use a proper tool, you can not only get the information about the individual, but also to whom he is associated with, to the other person, can also be collected. So my suggestion, based on the experience, but I'm not marketing a particular company, UFED can provide in-depth analysis of the social media of the different, I mean the different social medias of the phones that are all installed. Okay, any question, any doubt so far? You can also type in your question. I will be very happy to see your questions and answers. Thank you, Santosh. I will get back to you once I check with the tool available with the manual that I have. Any questions so far? Any point that you want me to cover, I will try to cover until my the information to you. My teacher used to tell me there are two reasons for no question from the audience. My teacher used to tell me there are two reasons if there is no question from the audience. The first reason is that whatever you are speaking or telling to the audience is so crystal clear that there is no question. The second reason is that everything is going bouncer, wide, na bat pe laga, na pat pe laga. So there is no question. I hope it is not the second reason for no question. Shall I continue if there is no question?
Yes, sir, you can continue, sir.
Okay, thank you. Someone creates a fake, yeah, that's a question. Deepak Mishra has given, if someone creates a fake profile on a social media platform, is it possible to trace the culprit? Absolutely, it is possible. There are few links I will share after a few slides, and I will tell you the method. You can try it and use it. Okay. So far, any question? I mean, so far the topic that I have covered, any question from that? Okay. So let me go to the slightly other part of the mobile phone domain. So tracking, police used to know, हमने तो CID serial में, movie में, और नो जो कुछ भी जो APC serials आते हैं TV में देखते हैं, police used to track the phone. हाँ, यही location है, यही पता चल गया. ये कैसा करते हैं? How they do that? Yes. There are three methods of tracking a mobile phone. The first method that followed is carrier based location. Yani ki the person's call data, CDR or IPDR, internet protocol address. I'll fake email ID. I will how can we make out that the Yeah, I will talk about the fake email ID in few minutes. Okay. So carrier based. How this carrier based using the call data record CDR or internet protocol data record IPDR. When a person uses the phone for talking or receiving a call, the tower IDs are recorded in the call data record. If I analyze the call data record from morning 10 o'clock to evening 5 o'clock, one particular tower is used to receive the call, means the person's office is located in this nearby tower. From night 10 o'clock to morning 6 o'clock, only the same tower is shown as call receiver. That means it might be his residence. So like this, we used to calculate and find the location, but this is not a live location. It is a older, yani ki history based. Call history se hum pata kar sakte hain, haan bhai yehi mein rehta hai, itna din se call yehi par aa raha hai. Live kaisa karein sir? How do we do the live forensics? Live tracking. That is the concept called triangulation method. We have a concept called triangulation method. आप समझा होगा, अरे सर मेरा फोन बंद पड़ा है, इतना साइलेंट है, किसी से कुछ बात नहीं हो रहा है. That is wrong. Our phone in every 30 seconds sends a ping command. Hello, I am here. The ping command will be received by the nearby towers of your place. Minimum 3 towers will surely receive. But the thing is that each tower might be receiving in a different time. The tower which is located near will get the signal first. The next tower will receive little later, and the farther tower will receive little much later. So you know which frequency at what time interval it will take. So based on that, we can put a map. अरे यार इस समय में इतना लेट से ये रिसीव किया है, यानी कि इतने दूर पे ये टावर से सेंटर में रख लो, या इतने रेडियस में हम ये रख सकते हैं करके सर्कल डालेंगे. तो यू कैन पुट थ्री सर्कल्स, यानी कि थ्री टावर का सर्कल डालोगे, एंड वेयर द थ्री टावर सर्कल्स इंटरसेक्ट्स, दैट इज द लोकेशन द फोन इज लोकेटेड. But you cannot guarantee there is a mismatch. That is 1 meter se lete hue 50 meter tak wo mismatch kar sakta hai because of the place where the phone is located. Yani ki wo ghar ke andar hai ya koi dusre tower se diwar ke piche hai ya basement mein hai. So based on all this factor, the accuracy will depend upon all these factors. Okay, this is the second method. थर्ड मेथड, आजकल तो ना मोबाइल फोन हम फोन बात करने के लिए इस्तेमाल नहीं करते, बहुत कम इस्तेमाल करते हैं। वी यूज टू यूज द फोन टू टॉक वेरी लेस, बट वी इंस्टॉल सो मेनी एप्लीकेशन, फेसबुक, व्हाट्सएप, टिंडर, ऑल यू नो डिफरेंट डिफरेंट एप्स आर देयर। ऑल दिस एप्स फर्स्ट दे से अलाउ मी द लोकेशन, अलाउ मी द जीपीएस टू एक्सेस, एंड दिस लोकेशन एक्सेस करके चुप बैठता है ना। अगर आप फेसबुक पे जीपीएस दे देते हैं तो आराम से बोलेगा टुडे दिल्ली एयरपोर्ट डॉट 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 2 आवर्स, बॉम्बे एयरपोर्ट, हाँ भाई दिल्ली से बॉम्बे जा रहा है एयरपोर्ट, एरोप्लेन में गया है ये। यस, योर लोकेशंस आर ट्रेस आर शोड टू द वर्ल्ड लाइक दिस, एंड देर आर सम एप्स लाइक स्विगी, जोमैटो, ओला, उबर, विदाउट जीपीएस दिस विल नॉट वर्क। इफ ए पर्सन हैज गॉटन मेथड टू एक्सेस द डेटा, गया काम से, ईच एंड एवरी मूवमेंट ऑफ योर लोकेशन कैन बी ट्रेस। बट सो फॉर सर्टन एप्स आर टफ एनफ, दे आर नॉट रिवीलिंग, बट देर आर पीपल, देर आर टूल्स अवेलेबल विच विल गैदर द इंफॉर्मेशन, एंड थोड़ी देर के बाद मैं कॉल करता मैं कॉल करता हूँ राइट। सो वन ऑफ द एप विच आई डोंट वॉन्ट यू टू डाउनलोड इन योर नॉर्मल फोन, यूज अ डमी फोन, वुल्फ्लो एंड क्लॉक सोशल सेंस, इट माइट हैव सम मैलिशियस कोड। अगर दूसरे से चुराने की कोशिश करता है तो ये भी मैलिशियस कोड लेके आएगा। सो दिस फोन्स, दिस एप्लीकेशंस कैन प्रोवाइड यू द डिटेल्स ऑफ अदर पर्सन लोकेशन, इट माइट कंटेन मैलिशियस, बी केयरफुल। अपार्ट फ्रॉम दैट, इफ यू वॉन्ट टू लोकेट और इफ यू वॉन्ट टू ट्रेस सम ऑफ योर फैमिली मेंबर्स, स्पेशली पेरेंट वॉन्ट टू ट्रैक द चिल्ड्रन, दे कैन यूज द एप्लीकेशन कॉल्ड पेरेंशियल कंट्रोल एप्लीकेशन। मेरे एक पुराने एक सीनियर ऑफिसर थे, उन्होंने बोला अरे यार मेरे बच्चे को फोन देना चाहता हूँ, सिक्योर मेथड बताओ, पेरेंट कंट्रोल बताओ। तो आई टोल्ड हिम दैट दिस पर्टिकुलर एप्लीकेशन इज देयर सर, इट विल नॉट ओनली कंट्रोल द फोन बट इट विल ऑल्सो ट्रैक योर चिल्ड्रन। देन ही स्टार्ट यूजिंग दैट फोन, आफ्टर फ्यू डेज ही कॉल्ड मी अगेन, अरे यार ये टूल बहुत अच्छा काम करता है, ये मेरा दूसरा फोन है इसमें डाल दो, ये तो आपसे दो लड़के हैं, दो लड़के को दे दिया, ये किसका है, अरे यार ये मेरी वाइफ का है। सो पीपल ट्राई टू मिस यूज, बट यू नो पेरेंटल कंट्रोल टूल इज ऑल्सो वेरी गुड फॉर ट्रैकिंग। एंड देर इज वन मोर टूल कॉल्ड आईपी लॉगर, आई हैव नॉट मेंशन हियर, आईपी लॉगर, दिस इज सिंपल एप्लीकेशन आईपी लॉगर, यू कैन डाउनलोड इट इन योर मोबाइल फोन, पुट द यूआरएल ऑफ द पर्सन और द इमेज और द इंफॉर्मेशन विच द टारगेट लाइक्स, यानी कि मैं XYZ को मैं टारगेट है वो मेरा, उसको मैं ढूंढना चाहता हूं कहां पर है, तो XYZ को जो पसंदीदार इंफॉर्मेशन, से फॉर एग्जाम्पल ही लाइक्स दीपिका पटकोने, आई विल पुट दीपिका पटकोने फोटो इन द आईपी लॉगर, द यूआरएल इन द आईपी लॉगर, एंड इट विल क्रिएट ए न्यू यूआरएल, दैट न्यू यूआरएल आई विल व्हाट्सएप हिम टू हिस नंबर, द टारगेट XY को नंबर को मैं मैसेज भेजूंगा। द मोमेंट XYZ ने जो यूआरएल को टच किया, ओपन किया, इट विल रिप्लाई बैक द मैसेज, द आईपी एड्रेस मेरा आईपी लॉगर को भेजेगा, फ्रॉम दैट आई कैन लोकेट ये आईपी कौन सा लोकेशन पे है, कहां पे कहां का आईपी एड्रेस है, इसका लोकेशन हमें पता लगता है। 90% एक्यूरेसी ये बता सकता है, 10% इसमें एक्यूरेसी गलत हो सकती है। डोंट ब्लेम मी सर, आपने ये बोला हमने इस्तेमाल किया, गलत लोकेशन दिखा रहा है, आई हैव ऑलरेडी टोल्ड 10% इट विल नॉट शो एक्यूरेटली, बट यू कैन ट्राई। ओके राइट, Any question regarding mobile phone, you can ask me. I will go for the social media in next few seconds. There's a question. You explained the method during seizure of phone, which will be helpful to stop signal to reach the phone. But Google is able to track our location even if phone is switched off. Then isn't it contradictory, sir? Google cannot access your phone when your phone is switched off. There is no device when it is switched off, it will access your location. आप बंद कर दिए, बंद कर दिए. मे बी यू हैव यूज्ड सम अदर डिवाइस. आपके पास दो तीन मोबाइल फोन रहेगा, सेम गूगल का ये रहेगा, तो आप उसमें लोकेट करवा सकते हो. अगर मेरा फोन स्विच ऑफ कर दिया है, नो, गूगल कैनॉट ट्रेस. ओके, राइट, गुड क्वेश्चन. Any other question regarding the mobile phones, you can ask now. Too boring? No, those YouTube are prank videos. There are you must be very careful in watching or learning from YouTube. बहुत फटाते हैं, बहुत मजाक मस्करी करते हैं, और नीचे बहुत आखिर में बोला होगा, you have to read the review. Review में पढ़ के आपको पता चल जा रहा है यार, फेंक रहा है यार, ये सब कुछ नहीं है यार. ये सब देखने के लिए मजा है. इफ देयर इज नो गूगल अकाउंट रनिंग इन द फोन, कैन इट स्टिल बी ट्रेस्ड? यस, इफ आई हैव एक्सेस टू हिज जीपीएस और एनी ऑफ द मेथड, आई कैन ट्रेस इट. गूगल ऑलवेज finds and updates through the account. If there is no Google account, through other means we can trace. Okay, right. So mobile phones, if there is no question from mobile phone, let me go to the social media. I hope it is still sufficient time is there. I think the next 45 minutes is available for me. I hope. Is it okay? Correct?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Right. Is there any break to be given in between, or shall I continue?
No,
because it's
too over. You can continue, sir. We will end the session by 4, sir. So you can continue.
Okay. Thank you.
Thank you so much.
So social media. Let us see the social media ecosystem first, so that थोड़ा बहुत bore नहीं लगना, थोड़ा सा फोरेंसिक से अलावा भी थोड़ा बात करना है. देयर इज अ क्वेश्चन, हाउ टू स्टॉप एसएमएस बॉम्बार्डिंग, सर? बंद फोन बंद कर दो, कोई एसएमएस ही नहीं आएगा. यू कैन यूज डीएनडी डू नॉट डिस्टर्ब ऑप्शन, दैट इज द मेथड, और यू हैव टू ब्लॉक. ओके, सो द सोशल मीडिया इकोसिस्टम. Earlier we used to have desktop computers, so people developed their social media, especially kuch information bhejna hai, lena hai, utna hi tha. Then there comes the tablets, thoda sa mobile aane laga, yani ki you can take it and go, your computers are in your hand. Pehle palm top bhi bolte the, laptop ke baad palm top bolte the. So when it becomes tablet, you can move around and playing games and other things a part of the social media. I still remember people who use the Facebook, they might be playing Farmville. Itna khelte the, itna karte the, aur hame bhi message dete the, tum bhi jam jao, you also join, I will get this much of money for building my farm. So that was the thing. Then the device becomes network interactive, standalone tablet ne tha, interaction mein aa gaya, instantaneously interaction mein tha. Tab they start using the method called buying, selling, networking. Then smartphones aane laga, where individual internet or location GPS based aane laga. To localization, Foursquare, इतना सब कुछ आ गया. सो दिस इज व्हाट द इकोसिस्टम एट प्रेजेंट वी हैव द स्मार्टफोन्स लोकलाइज्ड स्मार्टफोन्स राइट. And if you take the social media, you can compare each and every social media with one kind of activity we do in our day-to-day life. Kuch bhi chahiye, kuch cheez ko aap dekhna chahte ho, you will peep from your window and look into the world. So similarly, we have YouTube. Khana kaisa banana hai? YouTube mein dekh lo. Kaun sa device lena hai? YouTube mein dekh lo. So whatever you want to look into the outside world, you use the YouTube. Similarly, आप professional चीज में आपको दुनिया भर को देना है, दिखाना है या देखना है, you use LinkedIn. LinkedIn पे है आप? हाँ, आपका पूरा professional details पे है, कहाँ काम पे आ, क्या पढ़ा, सब कुछ है. हाँ भाई, LinkedIn पे है मेरा account. आप छोटे photos को ये करना है, Tumblr हो गया. सबका एड्रेस चाहिए, सब कहां पर है, क्या क्या कर रहे हैं दुनिया में, आपके दोस्त कहां क्या कर रहे हैं, फेसबुक में आ जाओ, सबका अता पता चल जाएगा. सो लाइक दिस एवरी सोशल मीडिया हैज गॉट सम वे ऑफ रोल टू बी प्लेड इन आवर डे टू डे लाइफ एंड इट प्रोवाइड्स सो मच ऑफ इंपैक्ट. एंटरटेनमेंट सोशल मीडिया, माई मदर इज अराउंड 80 years old. She uses YouTube. She uses WhatsApp videos to watch. अरे यार, WhatsApp में आज बोला है कोई बरसात आएगा. Be careful, today it will be raining. See the impact. Information इतना ज्यादा भागता है. Communication, you can quickly disseminate. Just a second. इट एक ही ग्रुप में डालो, बस सेकेंड्स में कम्युनिकेशन रीच हो जाएगा. इन्फ्लुएंस, बंदा इतना करोड़ों का रुपए डाल के एक मूवी बनाता है, सेकेंड्स में मूवी, फर्स्ट डे फर्स्ट शो देख के हम डालते हैं इंफॉर्मेशन. अरे यार, घटिया मूवी है यार, गया काम से, इन्फ्लुएंस हो गया मूवी फ्लॉप. And it plays an important role as evidence. Yes, social media information can also be used as evidence. Matrimony issue, पति पत्नी का केस, डाइवोर्स केस चल रहा है कोर्ट में. पति ने किसी के साथ फोटो शादी का डाल दिया, पत्नी आ गई फोटो लेके, सर दिस इज अ फोटो दैट फेलो हैज पुट, ऑलरेडी मैरिड, आई एम द फर्स्ट वाइफ, टेक एक्शन. Yes, court looks up. So like this, it is a very valuable source. It has the got the evidentiary value. But evidentiary value banne ke liye, it has to be something, you know, important factors it must have to become evidentiary value. Yes, it has got all. Defensibility. It can be made defensibility. It is a made defensible, reproducible result. Same photo ही अभी भी निकाल सकता हूँ, जब भी देखा, हाँ सर ये है, ये डाला हुआ है, reproducible result. Accept the tools and technique. When I download, the downloading method, the technique is also acceptable by the court. Proper evidence handling and documentation. Yes, it is also possible to document. ये काम पर है, कैसा है, और उसको कैसे handle करना है. That is also be done. And the very important thing, application of scientific method. ये ऐसा कोई नहीं है सर, कोई डाल दिया है, उसको देख दिखता है, कभी दिखता है, कभी नहीं दिखता है. इट इज विजिबल समटाइम, इट इज नॉट विजिबल समटाइम, इट इज नॉट लाइक दैट. इट कैन बी प्रॉपरली साइंटिफिकली लाइक अ पोस्टमार्टम वी टेक सर्टेन एविडेंस, सेम वे वी कैन आल्सो फॉलो साइंटिफिक मेथड्स टू टेक द एविडेंस आउट. presentation of metadata, not only the real data, data about data, which is called metadata, can also be taken and presented in the court. So let us see few methods how this can be done. Yes, the first method is the very simple and useful method. Even if you have faced any issue with the social media, this is what it is recommended: screenshot. Agar koi aapke upar, if somebody has defamed you and put some information in the social media, how to go to the police, or if you go to the police, what the police will do? Screenshot layout, screenshot nikalo. Whatever that is available on the screen has to be captured. Now few people might be having a question, sir, how come the screenshot be a scientifically accepted, sir? Say if I take the screenshot now, not only the PPT but also the go to meet wala bhi aa jayega, it is a mixing of information and I am giving the tampered information. Yes, you are absolutely right. When you take the screenshot, don't just take the screenshot only, yaniki you also need to take the, say for example, I'll just show you. You also need to take the source code. Say for example, let me go to Facebook. If this is the Facebook page and this is the screen that has it is there, so I take the screenshot, iska screenshot le liya, usse hi simit ho gaya? No, I must go to the source code, right click on the screen, and you can see something called view page source, and it will open the source code page. This is what the page source code, not only the screen, the source code has to be selected and it has to be pasted in the place where you have taken the screenshot. So select all, control C, go to the word document, jo screenshot liya hai us word document mein source code bhi dal lo, aur paste this screenshot as well. So this is what the source code bhi aa gaya. Isse kya hota hai, we can confirm the information available in the screen, the screenshot is what the source code, in the source code form I recreate into the HTML or any other browser mein open karunga, sirf wohi dikhega, if no other extra thing will not be visible. So this is the simple and the accepted way, the first method of collecting the evidence. So screenshot plus the source code has to be taken. Sir, mere jo defame karne ke liye the person has put a video, he has not put just a photo, he has put a video. How can I take the video into the screenshot, sir? Ek hi frame dikhega. I need to take the continuous video also. For that purpose, we need to take something called screen capturer. Then the video of the screen will also be captured. Cam Studio, a tool called Cam Studio. This tool can capture not only the screen but the running video with audio can also be captured. So the video is there, you have to use the Cam Studio to capture the video that is visible in the social media along with the source code. This is what the recommended procedure. The next method, manual documentation. What is this manual documentation? Yes, your Facebook, your Twitter, your Instagram, all this social media has got something called backup option. It will always take the backup. Wo backup leta hi rehta hai. अगर उस बैकअप को आप डाउनलोड करोगे यू कैन डू सो मच ऑफ फोरेंसिक्स. आई जस्ट वांट टू टेल यू अ स्मॉल केस स्टडी आई केस आई हैव हैंडल्ड. अ बॉय रिसीव्ड सम अनवांटेड अगली मैसेजेस फ्रॉम द गर्ल. When the boy go and ask the girl, she says, you are only sending the message to me. I am ignoring. Why you come and fight? Shout at me. आपकी गलती, तुम्ही भेज रहे हो, मैं प्रिंसिपल से कंप्लेंट कर दूंगी. तो जाके कंप्लेंट भी कर दी. देखो ये मुझे गंदा गंदा मैसेज भेज रहा है और मुझे वापस मुझे ही डांट रहा है. Then the case was referred. Indirectly it came to me. सर बच्चों का मामला है, पुलिस थोड़ा सा ये नहीं करना चाहती है, थोड़ा सा आप बता बनाओ. Then I told. Is the both the boy and girl are cooperating to give the information? Yes. Then I told, tell them to download the backup data. Facebook mein you can go to the settings. Thoda aage piche hota hai, magar there is a concept called copy. Download a copy of your Facebook backup. So they accepted this and both of them gave the backup data. After 2 days. I received the backup data and I start analyzing. Backup data provides so much of information from the day you create your account till today, whatever you have done, even whatever you have searched, you have done will be available. What information you posted will be available. What information you deleted will be available. Not only that, from which IP address you accessed, from which device you accessed, from which browser you opened or which application you opened will be available. This was not known to the boy. And when I was analyzing, I found that the girl's account showed boy's IP address. Girl's account shows boy's IP address. ये कैसा हो सकता है? यानी कि the boy know the girl's username and password. He opened the Facebook account of the girl through his device, start putting vulgar messages and टू हिमसेल्फ. यानी कि वो लड़की के अकाउंट से अपने आप को मैसेज भेज दिया और देन ही स्टार्टेड गोइंग एंड फाइटिंग विद द गर्ल. यू हैव पुट द वल्गर मैसेज. नाउ व्हेन आई आस्क द बॉय, बोल बेटा क्या है तेरा? ना सर मैंने कुछ नहीं किया. सचमुच ये समय में ये डिवाइस किसके पास था? तेरा पास था. ये क्या है? देन He accepted, सर मुझे लड़की का पासवर्ड पता था, थोड़ा सा लड़ाई हो गई थी, मैं इसको ये करना चाहता था तो इसके लिए मैंने कर दिया. सो द डाउनलोडेबल कॉपी प्रोवाइड सो मच ऑफ इंफॉर्मेशन. कुछ भी करने की जरूरत नहीं है. अगर कोई भी फेसबुक या ट्विटर या टिंडर या टम्बलर, टिंडर में नहीं रहेगा, टम्बलर इसमें पूरा आपका बैकअप रहेगा. आप डाउनलोड कर सकते हो, आप उसमें एनालाइज कर सकते हो. फेसबुक में तो बहुत बढ़िया मिलेगा. ओके, दैट्स अ क्वेश्चन. लेट मी सी द क्वेश्चन. हाउ वी चेक इन फोरेंसिक दैट वेदर द ऑडियो वीडियो इमेज स्टैम्पर्ड और ओरिजिनल? तो आप मुझे वीडियो ऑडियो फोरेंसिक का क्लास लगाते हो. व्हेन यू कॉल मी फॉर वीडियो एंड ऑडियो आई विल टेल अबाउट दैट. Let me see if the time permits, I will tell you in the end. Okay? Is it okay, Bilal? I will try to tell you at the end of this. If it has got its time, I will try. Okay? So, this is what the method. Sir, agar mere paas backup copy bhi nahi mila, I am not able to take the backup copy. What can I do? There is a tool called HTTrack. There's a tool called HTTrack. It is an open source tool. Actually, this tool is used to copy the websites. अगर कोई वेबसाइट खोला है उस वेबसाइट को पूरा डाउनलोड कर लेगा अपने सिस्टम. This tool can be used to copy the visible Facebook detail and put it into your system. So ये जो कुछ भी लिंक का जो फेसबुक में एक ही लिंक में है ना, बहुत सारे लिंक होते हैं, यहां से वहां वहां से यहां पूरा जाके ये लेगा. इफ यू ओपन योर फेसबुक पुट द यूआरएल इनटू HTTrack इट विल टेक आवर्स. मैंने एक केस के लिए डाला था, रात भर वो डाउनलोड किया पूरा लिंक से तकरीबन 20-30 जीबी तक वो डाउनलोड कर लिया. सो मच ऑफ इंफॉर्मेशन इट विल डाउनलोड. दिस इज व्हाट HTTrack. Okay, next we have something called X1 discovery. This tool is again is a proprietary tool. It is not an open source proprietary tool. एंड इसका जो एडवांटेज है, इट टेक डाउन द इंफॉर्मेशन लाइक HTTrack बट पैक्स इट एंड पुट द हैश वैल्यू सो दैट इट कैन बी डायरेक्टली गिवन टू द कोर. जो HTTrack में मैंने डाउनलोड किया था उसको हैश वैल्यू बनाना पड़ेगा, या बैकअप में मैंने निकाला था उसको भी मैं हैश वैल्यू करना पड़ेगा, पैक करना पड़ेगा, स्क्रीनशॉट को भी मैंने वो पूरा इंफॉर्मेशन को पैक करके हैश वैल्यू लेना पड़ेगा. मगर X1 डिस्कवरी में एक बार ये वाला डेटा बोल दिया, इट विल गो एंड डाउनलोड इट, पैक इट, पुट द हैश वैल्यू, रेडी टू बी प्रोवाइडेड टू द कोर. इट इज अ प्रोप्राइटरी टूल. 5-6 lakh rupees तक होता है. Sir, if I don't have that much money, where to go? Is there any option, cheaper option? Yes, there is a cheaper option. Page Freezer. There is a site called Page Freezer. वो उतना पैसा नहीं लेगा, $5-$10 लेगा for a particular page. या social media का कोई data को वो pack करके download करके देगा. You can produce it to the core. So cheaper method, but not for all the data, only particular data you ask, for that they will charge and they will give the data. Sir, screenshot bhi nahi mila, backup bhi nahi mila, HTTrack bhi nahi hua, magar device haath lag gaya. I have caught hold of the device used by the criminal for putting or doing wrong using the social media. अभी तो social media वो log out कर दिया है sir. तो हम क्या करें, कैसा कुछ investigate करें, forensic activity क्या करें? We can do the analysis, browser cache analysis. Just not the history. History सिर्फ आपका URL बताएगा. Browser cache में whatever videos in between you have watched, that will also be captured. So you had to go to the browser cache, analyze the browser cache, what are all the activity related to the social media that has been done will be available there to an extent, and you can extract the data. This is what the browser cache. Sara, itna bhi karne ke baad kuch bhi nahi mila sir, nahi hua. Ultimate thing, send the summon to the service provider for asking the detail. So our law provides the mechanism through court to send the service provider to provide the detail. Law has provided, but social media will not provide the data, sir. 6-6 months हो गए, साल हो गए. The court has given summon, notice, everything. Their reply says privacy. Privacy? Yes. due to privacy or due to the law, I am not able to give this. By the way, do you know why most of the social media or internet or application related companies are located in California? Ek to rahega California, ek to rahega Ireland. You know why these two places their corporate office address is this one? America mein kahin par bhi reh sakta hai, but corporate office California diya hoga. Do you know why? In California there is a law, Community Decency Act, and in Community Decency Act there is section 240. It gives the blanket approval. You are not supposed to share the data to anybody, your client data to anybody. Bol diya, privacy matter. California mein jo कोई भी कंपनी है, कोई भी पुलिस जाके उनको ठोक नहीं सकती, पूछ नहीं सकती, डेटा दो ना. दैट इज द रीजन एवरीबडी हैव क्रिएटेड. सर ठीक है कैलिफोर्निया, व्हाट अबाउट आयरलैंड? सिमिलर कॉन्सेप्ट. प्राइवेसी इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर देम. प्राइवेट डेटा, इंडिविजुअल डेटा इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. दे आर वेरी सीरियस अबाउट नॉट गिविंग द इंडिविजुअल प्राइवेट डेटा. सो इन ऑर्डर टू अट्रैक्ट मोर कस्टमर्स, they say that your data is very secure with us because our corporate office is at California, at Ireland, or at Ireland, and the law gives protection to protect your data. We will not give to anybody. So that is the reason they have their office in the California or Ireland, and the police find it difficult, law enforcement agency find it difficult to get the data from them. That is the reason they never respond immediately. But due to the latest rule that has come, service provider, there is a support in Indian IT Act. Third party are not liable for the wrong. Yani ki, I am the criminal and a crime has happened. In order to do the crime, I use the Google search engine, I use some method to search the data, and I did the crime. Because of my using Google and doing the crime, police cannot put the third party Google into the A2, accused number 2, because it's supported in the crime. So IT Act says third party is not liable. The latest rule says you have to follow due diligence. If you don't follow due diligence, if you don't support the or follow the rule, this particular exemption will not be accepted to you. Due diligence, yes, there must be a person to respond to your query. There must be a officer in India, legal whatever thing he has to support. So like this, there are some contact email ID or method. Even there are names and phone number that is also available in the Google. You can also search. If there is an issue, you can contact them, and that person will provide you the detail as per the rule of the land. So you can approach this email IDs or to these persons to get your grievance. There is a grievance officer, and the grievances can be handled. Even the law enforcement agencies can approach for instantaneous support on the cases. Any question, any doubt so far? Can a chat history of any debate on any issue among friends be traced and accepted as evidence? And if your user deleted his account, then such history can be chat history can be collected, yes, but not थ्रू द इंडिविजुअल, मतलब इंडिविजुअल अकाउंट जो बैकअप मिलेगा उसमें मिलेगा, और फ्रॉम द फेसबुक इटसेल्फ वी कैन कलेक्ट. Even it is deleted also, Facebook can provide and we can trace through the Facebook it is possible. But not, I cannot assure with other, but through Facebook it is possible. Okay? Any other question? Good. Any other question? Right. So far I have told you about the evidence that can be collected, but social media is just not used for collection of evidence but for intelligence as well. Information about others, yes, before any crime happens or before any incident happens, you must be in a position to gather the information. We have something called OSINT, open source intelligence. One is OSINT and another is OSEM, OSEM intelligence. Any key online social media intelligence using OSINT, open source intelligence. What is this OSINT? Yes, so much of information how to recover the data or deleted data from a protected smartphone. You need to have a particular tool according to the OS. For example, I mean, there is a question, how to recover the data or deleted data from the protected phone. I hope protected phone matlab password protected phone. If it is a password protected phone, the first method is, there are tools like UFED will break the password and it will find the password, and using that method it will access the phone data, extract the data. Number two, it will bypass the password and it will go to the phone, extract the data. This is the method that we can use to extract the data from the mobile phone. It includes both data presently available as well as data that was deleted. So you can do both the things. I hope Arjun might have understood this, and Uttraksh Jain sir, can Facebook provide chat history of past 80 years? Arey bap re bap, I think Facebook is not that much old. Facebook is very young. I hope it is not more than 15 or 20 years, not more than 20 years sure for that. Okay, so you can get 20 years jis din Facebook paida hua us din se le sakte, theek hai? और जिस दिन आप अकाउंट ओपन किया उस दिन से ले सकते हो, नॉट 80 ईयर्स, उतना पुराना नहीं है वो, राइट. सो द मेथड दैट कैन बी यूज्ड फॉर द इंटेलिजेंस, द थ्री मेथड्स वी अडॉप्ट, द फर्स्ट वन इज इनडायरेक्ट मेथड, द सेकंड इज डायरेक्ट मेथड विदाउट लॉगिंग इन, थर्ड मेथड इज डायरेक्ट मेथड विथ लॉगिंग इन. यानी कि फर्स्ट मेथड, यू विल नॉट गो टू एनी सोशल मीडिया, यू विल सर्च फ्रॉम द अदर मेथड्स. बाबा से पूछेंगे, बाबा गूगल बाबा से पूछेंगे, बिंग बाबा से पूछेंगे, और थोड़े और भी बाबा है उनसे पूछेंगे और डेटा लेंगे. दूसरा मेथड है, आई विल गो टू द सोशल मीडिया बट लॉग इन मेरा एड्रेस दे के लॉग इन नहीं करूंगा, वहां पे जाके ढूंढूंगा मगर मेरा एड्रेस नहीं दूंगा, मेरा क्रेडेंशियल यूजर नेम नहीं दूंगा. द थर्ड मेथड, दूसरा रास्ता ही नहीं है सर, मेरा क्रेडेंशियल देना पड़ता है, यूजर नेम पासवर्ड देख के सर्च करना पड़ता है. सो देयर आर थ्री मेथड्स दैट इज फोरेंसिकली और फॉर द पर्पस ऑफ इंटेलिजेंस यूज एक्सेप्टेड मेथड्स. लेट अस सी द मेथड्स, सिंस देयर इज अ पॉसिबिलिटी ऑफ टाइम, आई विल नॉट, आई विल स्किप सर्टेन पॉइंट्स एंड आई विल गो टू द रिक्वायर्ड थिंग. यस, जैसे मैंने बोला गूगल, यू कैन गो फॉर द गूगल. इफ यू वॉन्ट टू सर्च ए पर्टिकुलर पर्सन, ए पर्सन कुछ नाम से आप सर्च करना है, पुट एट एंड दैट पर्टिकुलर पर्सन नेम, इट विल सर्च द सोशल मीडिया वाला नाम में से जो निकला वो आएगा. दूसरा है टॉपिक. टॉपिक में जो जो बातचीत चलती है हैशटैग. हाँ हैशटैग से नाम होता है हैशटैग मी टू. हाँ भाई यस द टॉपिक वॉज डिस्कस्ड. सो यू कैन सर्च अबाउट द टॉपिक एंड द टॉपिक विल बी अवेलेबल. सो यूजिंग दिस मेथड यू कैन सर्च. देयर इज वन मोर थिंग कॉल्ड सोशल सर्च डॉट कॉम. अगर कोई भी इंफॉर्मेशन जो सोशल मीडिया में जो कुछ भी जितने जितने हैं, आई जस्ट पुट दिस शो इट टू यू, इट विल बी इजी फॉर यू. Yes, so I can put a thing. What is the hot topic we have today? So Facebook में यानी sorry I have not whatever I have to here click here and it will search. I put very simple here. क्योंकि format का जो आएगा पूरा निकल गया. Yes. जहां कहीं पर भी है पूरा आएगा. जहां कहीं farmer नाम आया था सो वेर एवर दिस फार्मर्स नेम इज दैट इन ऑल द फेसबुक में क्या है, ट्विटर में क्या है, इंस्टाग्राम में क्या है, एवरीथिंग विल बी देयर. ओके so this is how the social media search can be done. So like this there is something called social mention. Whatever I am doing from the openly available, I am not going to any site and searching. I am openly searching the data. Okay, similarly this site can be used to search the details about the keyword that you put. Spookio is again one more site, but it's a paid site. AB जो कुछ भी आपने पहले बोला था ना, एक बंदा फेक इंफॉर्मेशन डाल दिया है, फेक डिटेल डाल दिया है, वो भी यहां से हम देख सकते हैं. यानी कि यू टाइप दैट पर्टिकुलर नेम एंड यू कैन फाइंड हु इज द पर्सन, व्हाट अकाउंट ही हैज गॉट, विच प्लेस ही बिलोंग टू विल बी अवेलेबल. नाउ डायरेक्ट विदाउट लॉगिंग इन, यानी कि दिस आर द साइट विच विल गो टू द पर्टिकुलर सर्विस प्रोवाइडर, बट यू विल नॉट लॉगिंग इन. बैक ट्वीट, यानी कि ट्विटर के कितने पुराने ट्वीट्स है वो पूरा दिखाएगा. वेब इंस्टा इंस्टाग्राम का डिटेल बैठाएगा, टम्बलर का डिटेल दिखाएगा. सो लाइक दिस इट विल शो ऑल दिस थिंग. हियर आई हैव समथिंग वेरी नाइस वेबसाइट. दिस यू आर एल कैन शो अस the latest tweets that were been tweeted with a map. 1millionTweetMap.com. दुनिया भर के इस समय में कौन कौन ट्वीट कर रहे हैं, कर रहा है वो पूरा दिखेगा. So let me go to the India. अभी इतना सारा ट्वीट हुआ है. और now let me go to the Delhi. 17,000 tweets are there. In particular this place this many tweets are there, Faridabad, and in this place this many tweets, this place. Let me go, I can just scroll, I'm scrolling it and going it in deep. Karol Bagh, in Karolbag location bhi daya hai. Yes, somebody posted this photo, this person, these things are there, and this particular tweet in this place, happy birthday, something is there here. So like this, whoever tweet, those tweets can be seen, and we can see who has tweeted that. This particular thing can be very much useful when ek bar danga fasad hua tha kuch state mein, wahan se bola tha re yaar tweets to block bhi karna nahi pate hain aur allow nahi hua hai aur isko hum analyze karna chahte hain. So this was recommended, and before anyone starts spreading the rumors, people get to know where it is being posted, and police can take immediate action against those person who are posting it. So this is one of the very nice site, we can use it. 1 million tweet map is the site. Now we have other option, direct method with logging in, yani ki we have to log in to the site with our credential or somebody's credential, and then you can do the search. There are some sites, not only from Facebook, dusra social bro, similar web, app buzosumo.com, ye wala site to nahi hai sir, ye kahan se aa gaya, but this site will use your credential to access, to do something called sentimental analysis. What is the sentimental analysis? Yes, the information posted by this topic, what is the information, yani ki is the information is positive, koi acha bol raha hai, ya negative, yani ki koi iska upar negative bol raha hai, ya neutral. So like this you can do the sentiment analysis and get to know how this particular topic is being discussed among the public. So these are all the sites that can be used for the sentiment analysis and for finding the fake IDs, fake information, fake videos, leaked out information, hacked information. These are all the sites that can be used to find. I will share, or you can note down this. You can use it by yourself. I think the time is not available that much. I will go for the question answer now. You can ask questions and doubts now. I have 5 minutes more. If there's a question, what is the legal way to prove that someone has hacked somebody's social media account? See, the log of the account will show the IP address from where it has been accessed. If you are not using the particular IP address, and you can confirm that the IP address belongs to the other person, you can prove it. Or if you have the system, the offender system with you, and his system has got the cash details of the account, then also you can prove. Okay, what is that? One time delete and delete from everyone are the two major issues. Once it is deleted, it is quite difficult to recover, only on certain situations. Till it is available on the RAM or the volatile memory, you can get, or if it is in the backup, the copies in the backup, and after getting it backup you have deleted, then the backup or the RAM or the volatile memory can give you the detail. Otherwise no possible to get the delete from everyone. and automatic chat direct options. Can we get the slide data that has presented? Sure, I'll share with I don't know, the administrators. I'll try to share with them.
Yes, sir. Would
Hello. Okay.
Hello.
Yes, sir. Please, sir.
Sir, my voice is coming, sir. Now.
Yes, it is clear now. Please.
Yes, sir. Sir, this is Lieutenant Arjun Chaudhary here. Yes, sir. It's pleasure is all here, sir. And I'm really thankful, sir. You accepted our invitation and gave us a wonderful talk here. And must say, sir, I was just sitting with the chair and listening to you all, like the new ways of getting the OS end, and the way you just demonstrated the tools. Like, there are a variety of tools. Either, like, most of the time when we listen to the speakers, they usually talk about the tools which are out of our reach, actually, you know. And but yes, you told us the tools like the, which can be used freely as well, because that is the major concern with all of us, like, because of the paucity of the funds, because of the support and little bit support from the government side, we usually don't have the tools and the everything. So sir, it's a pleasure, it's an honor, and thank you so much, sir, for enlightening us, all of us. Okay, sir. And, there is one more question, sir, like from the audience side, that what are the latest research areas related to the digital forensic for researchers in current IoT era?
Okay. IoT, you know, is a very big area nowadays. From prevention as well as from forensic. Yani ki, to be secure, you have to do certain things. And in case if any wrong happen, you need to go deep into it and gather data. So IoT and AI, ML, these are all the places where you have to work. You can work a lot and get it. AI is a upcoming place where you can do a lot, and many devices are coming with AI, artificial intelligence and machine learning. Machine learning can also be used for better forensic activity, where repeated works are being conducted for profiling. AI ML is very helpful for us. Though it has got setbacks, but still a better way of writing the algorithm or getting in the algorithm can help us a lot.
Great, thank you so much, sir.
Thank you, sir. Now, sir, we are reaching to the end of the presentation, sir. Like, yes, feedbacks are already floating down to the chat box, sir. Very fruitful session. Great to learn about the new things and the technology.
I think great goes to Mr. Akash. I think Dr. Akash, he was the person who caught hold me when I met him. So many thanks to him, and the many thanks to the team, especially Lieutenant Chaudhary sir. Thanks a lot,
sir. Thank you, sir. Thank you. We'll again meet on some certain other platform, sir. Looking forward to be working with you, but learning from you. Thank you, sir.
Always.
Have a nice day, sir. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you all. Bye-bye. Bye-bye, sir. For the participants, tomorrow we are going to have the sessions again in the same schedule. The schedule has been mailed to all of you, and the attendance for the today's session and the feedback would be requested by every respective participants here. So thank you for your patience and listening to him and learning from the eminent research faculties here. So we'll be now leaving this particular meeting, and good day to all of you. Bye bye.